Hi my friends, how you all doing? Welcome back to the channel and welcome to a fresh episode of FM19 and the Hall of Famer. My friends, above is the link to last episode. That was the beginning of this current season. And I do need to throw this out there that FM20 is not far away. I genuinely think we've got at most two more seasons left in this save, unfortunately. Whether or not we're going to top the Hall of Fame, we'll have to wait and see. I'm going to go with it being very unlikely, but we will try our best to at least get as high up that Hall of Fame list as possible. And today, we could make giant strides towards it as we get our Champions League campaign underway. But we start by getting caught up, ladies and gents, as we always do. Last episode, if you've ruined it for yourself, we played Manchester United. 1-0 win. Excellent. Neither team were that great on the day. A penalty decided it. We played one game between last episode and this one. It was against Liverpool, the current champions or defending champions of the Premier League. And we got a 0-0 draw. We were not good in the game. I'm going to show you exactly what I mean by that. Two shots, none on target. We were dreadful. But the defence and the goalkeeper genuinely put in man of the match performances to starve off Liverpool. Although that says 16 shots, 6 on target, there was literally no highlights in the game. It was pretty poor, but I will happily take a draw against Liverpool. They are the best team in the league for a reason. So that gets us up to date. I'll show you the league table shortly. Today's episode, though, like I said last time, is going to be a cup double. We are going to do the Champions League Group C opening fixture against Paris Saint-Germain at home at the London Stadium. And then we're going to follow that up away at Molineux in the Carabao Cup third round. I'll play the game against Reading in between. Reading are a team we should really, really be beating, especially if we want to go after the Premier League this season, like I said last time out. So yeah, that is today's episode. It's going to be a good one. It's going to get feisty. Let's crack on. But first up, that league table. You'll see we are third place. Tottenham still 100% for the season. Us and Liverpool, 5 wins, 1 draw. So Tottenham top the league. And look at their goal difference, plus 20 already. They are flying, ladies and gents. I'm a little bit worried about them. I'm going to be honest. They're our closest rivals. And we had Liverpool to deal with last season. And this season, it looks like I've got Liverpool and Spurs to deal with. I want this Premier League crown at least once before this series is done and dusted. But let's do crack on, ladies and gents, because we've got a Champions League game to play, and it's against one of our old nemesis in Paris Saint-Germain. Oh, what hell they gave me when we were at Montpellier. Let's hope with West Ham we can do the business and absolutely destroy them in this group stage. They're so, so good though. I've taken a look at the team. We've had to rotate slightly because obviously weary legs and all that. We're going to be playing a lot of football this season, but this is the team we're going to go with, and I think it's the best team available to us. So we're going to go with Cajon in goal, Tadir and Alderete at fullback. Corbo and Ty are going to play centre-back in this game for us. Miles and Tijan are going to play centre-mid. Tijan is now happy to stay at the football club. Urda funk it, eh? Don't let him leave, and now he's happy. Kotterill and Novikov are going to play on the wings. We're going to go with Rob Dole in the attacking midfield position, and we're going to go with Caratini up top. Hopefully, he can score the goal that help us win this opening fixture in our Champions League group stage. So here we go, ladies and gents. PSG are going to get this game kicked off. I just want a positive result. I just want to get the group stages started with a draw or a win. Right, early corner to Paris Saint-Germain. 5 minutes in, but that's dealt with quite well. Miles, oh, he looked like he was going to get there. He got there on the second attempt. It was a good challenge. And now Tijan into Cotterill. We're going to have to keep an eye on Cotterill. He's just coming back from injury. Oh, that's good. Into Caratini. Oh, yes! Caratini on the third attempt puts us 1-0 up inside 5 minutes. Right, PSG on the ball. Oh, lovely stuff from Tadir to get in there and nick that ball. Right, Cotterill back to Tadir. Lovely stuff from him. Now to Tijan. Can we work this ball nicely? Dole is dropping deep. Tijan again. He finds Dole again. Oh, that was a lovely turn of pace there. Caratini going to go wide to Novikov. Lovely stuff. If he can find Caratini again, he could be in. He is in. He's 2-0. Come on, West Ham. Get in there. Right, free kick to West Ham, 23 minutes into this game. And Caratini showing his class in the game as Cotterill goes dancing through. He's still going. Oh, my God, what a goal that would have been. Right, throw in to West Ham, to Deer, into Dole. Good ball in. Oh, it was nearly on the head there, nearly for his hat trick, but it comes wide to Alderete. Oh, his cross doesn't quite come off, but it's all right. Tijan is there. If Tijan gets that ball, We could still be in business. Taido can't afford to lose it, and he has done to Dembele. Couture's through. Don't score. Oh, saved and onto the woodwork. Oh, good header from Ty. That was good from him. But PSG on the ball. I would like to get in at 2-0. A goal before half time really could shift the momentum into PSG's way. And Kempa comes forward. That's a ball into Orta, and it is going to be 2-1. That was really, really poor defending. Okay, at half time, it's not all doom and gloom, but I definitely need a bit more from the team. They've been good to a point. I am a little worried about Tijani. He's not having the biggest influence on this game, but he hasn't played a lot of football, to be fair to him, and Tadir as well. We're going to have to keep an eye on him. And our 6.7 isn't too bad, but his defensive work is questionable. Right, we're at the 60-minute mark. I think it's time for a change for two reasons. One, he's not having the best game, but two, he is just coming back, and I can't risk Cotterill getting injured. He's such an influence on this team. So we're going to bring Robertson on in his place to go out on the right side. Everybody else to this point is playing okay, so I think we're going to leave them. Wait and see what happens. At 2-1, though, it's still squeaky bum time for me. Right, throw in Alderete with it. Just please don't give it away. Dole, the smallest man on the pitch, has won that. Oh, Caratini's lost the ball. Come on, take that down, Corbo. Nothing silly. Can't afford to lose it. That's all right. Cajon into Ty. Ty's mistake in that first half, you know, it led to that goal, didn't it? Well, nearly led to a goal, I should say. Robinson into Dole. Come on. Come on, Novakov, get a ball in. Oh, Caratini! Get in there! Champions League hat-trick! We've won the game! Oh, ha, 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 Caratini. And we're getting one over on PSG as well by the looks of things. I'm fucking delighted at that. We are going to pull Caratini off, but Tucci's going to come on. Let's let him have his standing ovation. He scored a hat-trick. And when players are scoring goals like that, I always want them for the next game. So we're going to bring him off. And also, I think we're going to bring Tijan off, and we're going to bring Acosta on for him. Yeah, not long to go. We should now seal this result. Right, there is a throw-in, though, to PSG. Miles does well to win the header, but Rabiot now, and they've scored, and it's 3-2 with just a couple of minutes to go. Please hold on, West Ham. Please hold on. Maybe my celebrations were premature. No, maybe they weren't. There's just not long left now. Robinson, ball in, a call. What a save from Acosta's header that was. But surely now it's going to go for the corner. Referee blows the whistle. Massive result. All right, ladies and gents. So I did play that game against Reading, and a 5-0 victory. Absolute hammering at the hands of West Ham. You'll see that Caratini continuing his goal-scoring form. But then Maxi Robinson was the man of the moment. He got a hat-trick in this one and an assist at the game of his life. He really is starting to show some real potential as the young man, and a great understudy to Cotterill, what with his injury problems. But 5-0 is excellent. We now move on, as I said we would, to the Carabao Cup. All right, my friends, so here we go. We move on to the Carabao Cup fixture now. We are away from home at Molineux against Wolves. I've rotated the team. I've had no choice because the games are coming quick and fast, but hopefully this team will be good enough. I don't know what to expect from Wolves. They've recently been relegated. But yeah, we're going to go with Pekar in goal, Tadir, Garty on the fullback positions, Corbo and Hyundai in the centre-back positions. Helm, Tijan are going to play in the middle of the park. Robinson, Goretto on the wings. Benali in attacking midfield. Bertucci getting his chance up top. He may get relegated to these cup competitions because of how well Caratini's doing. So here we go, West Ham get the game kicked off. Last season, you will remember, a semi-final in this competition. I would love to go all the way this year. Right, throwing to Wolves. We're nearly at the 20-minute mark. It's actually a pretty even game. I thought my team would be strong enough to just really go out there and dominate, but Wolves putting on a hell of a display. Bertucci now out wide with the ball. There's no one in. Oh my God. There was nobody in the box. But he picks out Robinson and he bangs it away. Right corner. Benali. Ball in. Hyundai back post. He can't put it away. Another corner. Benali. Hyundai again. again, but this time Yonghyun Tae makes it 2-0. Throw in to Wolves once again. We seem to be starting a lot of highlights with a throw in to Wolves, but that's dealt with well at the back. Goretto now going to come forward. He loses the ball. Oh, Goretto, you got to do a bit more of it than that. That's a good challenge. Right, Goretto. Oh, he loses it again. How frustrating is that? But that's all right. That's going to fall to Robinson. And he's on fire. He finds Bertucci. Shot don't come off, but Robinson's does. That's his fifth goal in two games. Straight Insta highlight. Are we going to see Wolves score? Or could we potentially see us score again? Or it could just be a half chance. Who knows? But I'd like to think we are going to score. Robinson nicking that ball. And he just cleared it straight away. What if he'd have turned and run and scored another hat trick? Back-to-back hat tricks would have been lovely. That's a ball over the top though. And Gotti. Oh, he hasn't dealt with it very well. And it's fallen to Savayev. And that's 3-1. And that brings us to half time. And yeah, pretty good first half. 3-1. Would like to have kept a clean sheet against relegated Wolves. But yeah, two goals for Robinson. Two assists for Bertucci. Good stuff from the front line. Okay, there's 25 minutes left. Bertucci's had a relatively good game. Hasn't scored, but we are going to bring him off. And we're going to bring Bizamar on. We're going to give him a go in the cup. Let him get some football under his belt. We are also going to bring Goretto off and bring Novikov on. Not really been that impressed with Goretto in this game. But yeah, that makes us a little stronger. Let's continue this second half. All right, throw into Wolves. It's deep in their own half. Can we win the ball? It was back to the goalkeeper and should be dealing with that. And we didn't. And they've still got it. Jesus Christ. We are making a bit of a mess. Some of the challenges at the moment. Get out there, Tadeer. Instead, Corbo cleans up. But that's all right. Garty's going to take that down. Lovely ball into the path of Bizarma, who has put a ball in. And Robinson just wide. Right, we are just going to click that option. Ball in. Tadeer. Awful header from Tadeer. I don't understand why you would edit back in play if it's just going to go out. Oh, God. If Wolves get another chance without the defending, I worry. Why is he kicking that out? We don't play long from the back. Tadeer, that's a better header this time. I'm not convinced by Tadeer, by the way. He's into his second season now. Hasn't really developed. Bizarma, though, he might develop. That's a brilliant little goal on the shoulder of the defender and puts it away. Two good blocks there. Didn't really want to talk. I just had a feeling it was going to go in. 4-2 at the moment. It's been a bit of a game. Bizarma, look at you with a couple of tackles. Brilliant stuff from the new player. Oh, and then Novikov, though, gets taken out. Love to see that from the striker. Guy, he's going to nick in. Now, Benali, he's going to go into Helm. Back to Benali. Benali very deep in this passage of play. Novikov now into Helm. Comes out wide to Tijan. That's lovely ball out to Garty. Can he get one in the box? He can. And it's Max Robinson for back-to-back hat-tricks. So yeah, the game's finished. 5-2 winners. I just clicked forward and completely forgot to say goodbye from the game. Okay, so we find ourselves at the fixture screen, ladies and gents. What an episode. Plenty of goals. One of my viewers of this series has come up with a song that I keep meaning to bloody sing. What I will do is at the beginning of next episode, I will sing you the song. It's to the tune of Danny Boy. Yeah, I believe so. I will find it. I will sing it. I will let you know the lyrics. Because he calls the style of play that we play Danny Ball. Because he loves the amount of goals that we're scoring. Thank you very much. It's all to do with me and a tactic boy. But there we go. I don't know what accent that was. I'm in a very good place. We're winning football games. We scored. I know you didn't see the Reading game. We scored 13 goals in 3 games. Unbelievable. But next episode, let's talk about that before I explode. I think what we will do, because I do want to push on, I really do, because we only played one game between last episode and this one, so I do want to move it on a little bit. So I think I'm going to play Huddersfield, Porto, Everton and Chelsea off cam, and then next episode, which will be 114, I believe, I might do a free game episode. I really might. We'll play Celtic, Man City, and then whoever we get in the Carabao Cup. I would have done the draw today on today's episode, but I need to push it on about 3 or 4 days. And obviously, this is a long way in. There's a lot of leagues loaded. It takes time. I think I might do that. I might do a free gamer next time. So you'll definitely get to see us play City in the league and Celtic in the Champions League. We could be in a really good place if we beat Porto in that fixture. But yeah, I just kind of want to push it on a little. We'll face Celtic, we'll have Man City there, and then it'll be another game against Celtic, another against PSG, another against Porto. So yeah, it's lovely. We're in a good place. There's a lot of games I want to try and bring you this season, but I am conscious that I've got to wrap the series up in the next few weeks, what with FM20 around the corner. I mentioned it at the beginning of today's episode, I'm mentioning it at the end. I have to. I've got big plans. So before we leave, ladies and gents, I'm going to just show you the tables here, because obviously we have the Champions League to worry about as well. 3 points, a great win to open our Champions League campaign against Paris Saint-Germain. And as far as the Premier League is concerned, you'll see that we are third in the table. It's just goal difference basically keeping us there. The Tottenham dropped points, they drew with Watford, so we are all even Steven again. Bournemouth, look at Bournemouth. 18 points. Wowza. They are doing well and all. And at the moment, it's a bit of a four-horse race. You know, other teams are being left behind. The real surprise is Manchester United on 8 points in ninth, and Man City on 7, 12th in the league after 7 games played. So there you have it, ladies and gents. We are done and dusted for another episode of FM19 and the Hall of Famer. We are scoring plenty of goals. We are doing well in the cup competitions, but it's trucking along quite nicely in the league as well. Next episode will be a big one. Free gamer, my friends. I'll try and bring you as many games as possible between now and the end of the series. We've got lots and lots to get through, haven't we? But my friends, we are done for today. If you're new to the channel, please feel free to hit that subscribe button. It's really appreciated by your boy. Drop a like on this one as well if you've enjoyed it. That helped the channel massively. I don't think you realize just how important that is. But that is it, my friends. I've only got 2 more things left to say. The first is that you're all legends, and the second is that I'll see you all later.